शिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां सदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिश्रुतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरगुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने सोमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवामहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणि दधाति पूर्वं येदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तं प्रति आत्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्गणेशानुभवमयं सुकन्यकं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपाधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबुद्धिं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मरमपारं सर्वेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवान्नमत्वं निश्चितामतिः ज्ञानिनः इच्छादि संभवेपि व्यवहारे औदासीन्यम् So continuing with the topic of jnani having ichcha, which was mentioned earlier, due to prarabdha, his own prarabdha or paravasha, because of others prarabdha, there may be ichcha in jnani's mind. Even if ichcha is there, he is neutral to the Yavahara. So there is no particular choice in terms of, you know, since this Ichha is there, weighing that Ichha and tainting it with one's own Raga Dvesha, such things are not possible. And therefore, when one acts out the Ichha which has come up under the influence of Prarabdha, one is neutral to the act. So the jnani very well knows that it is due to prarabdha. So he does not have anything to claim in the act as to I want this result to take place, or I am the doer. In the first place itself, he is not the karta. And there is no bhoga in mind per se, it is just acting out the ichcha to get over with the prarabdha. So jnaninah sakala vyavaharah ajnyavat prarabdha vasha jayata iti prak abhihitam tadanukula ichcha api tasya sambhave deva. So all vyavahara is due to prarabdha. Here prarabdha vasha ajnyavat is one possible meaning, but what is better is sakala vyavahara ajnyavat. Sakala vyavahara ajnyavat, but not tainted by raga dvesha, purely prarabdha vashat. That's a better way to read it. This has been explained earlier. Tadanukula ichcha api tasya sambhave deva. Since vyavahara is possible, to facilitate such vyavahara, ichcha is also possible. यद्यपि अंतःकरणं भूतानां सत्त्वगुणकार्यम् इत्युक्तं तथापि रजस्तमोगुणसहित सत्त्वगुणकार्यम् एव तन्न न तु केवल सत्त्वगुणकार्यम्. सो तथापि रजस्तमोगुणसहित सत्त्वगुणकार्यम् एव तत् न तु केवल सत्त्वगुणकार्यम्. अंतःकरणं बीइंग अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ गुणास, देयरफॉर ऑल्दो प्रेडोमिनेंटली सात्विक, देयर इज ऑल्सो Rajas or Tamas, Rajas and Tamas, both. In a lesser measure, but they are still there even in the Jnani's Antakkarana. Otherwise, Jnani won't be able to sleep, won't be able to get up from the bed. So, if he has no Tamas, he won't be able to sleep at all. And if he has no Rajas, he won't even be able to get up from the bed, let alone do anything else. So, Rajoguna and Tamoguna are definitely there even in the Jnani's Antakkarana. तथापि रजस्तमो गुण सहित केवल केवल सत्वगुण कार्यं चेत् तत् स्यात् तदा अंतकरणस्य चंचल्य स्वभाव न कदापि स्यात्। सो चांचल्य ऑल्सो वोंट बी पॉसिबल इफ ओनली सत्वगुण बी देर इन द माइंड एंड दिस इज द टॉक ऑफ अंतकरण जनरली ट्रू विथ एवरीवन नॉट ओनली अ ज्ञानी। सो चांचल्य इज देर इन द अंतकरण ओनली ड्यू टू रजस एंड तमस तथा क्राम काम क्रोधाद्या राजस्यः वृत्तयः निद्रालस्य मूढत्वाद्याः तामस्यः वृत्तयश्च न स्युः। सो दि वृत्तयः राजस्य वृत्तयः एंड तामस्य वृत्तयः वोंट बी देयर इफ इट इज ओनली अ ओनली सत्वगुण इन दि अंतकरण और सत्वगुण कार्य देयरफॉर सत्वगुण अलोन विल बी देयर इन दि अंतकरण। Had it been so, then kama krodha ityadi, which are the products of rajas, won't be possible. And nidra alasya, mudatva, these are the results or these are the effects of tamoguna, those won't be there. Kintu apradani bhuta rajas tamoguna sahita sattva guna pradhana pancha bhuta karyam eva. So when we say the antakrana is a sattva guna karya, it is not purely sattvaguna, there is always some rajas and tamas there. So in the prakriya, when we look at it in tattva bodha, vedanta sara, wherever it is discussed, when only one guna is mentioned, the other gunas have some influence, especially in the case where only single guna is talked about. So other gunas definitely have influence, and it is clearly seen in the case of antakarana. So antakarana is also called a sattva. So sattva shuddhi is a word heard. Why? Because it is a sattva guna karya, but it doesn't mean only sattva guna. Sattva guna karya means pradhana is sattva. Others will definitely be there, which has been established here through anumana. Apradhani bhuta rajas and tamas will definitely be there. Tasmad antakarane trayopi ते गुणाः सर्वदा वर्तन्ते एव परन्तु न समतया। देयर इज नॉट एन इक्विलिब्रियम ऑफ ऑल दी थ्री गुणास। प्रीडोमिनेंटली देयर इज सत्व न्यूनाधिक भावेन तु वर्तन्ते तस्माद् गुणानां न्यूनाधिक भाववशात् प्रतिप्राणी विलक्षण स्वभावं अंतकरणम्। दी अंतकरण इज डिफरेंट बिकॉज दी डिग्री ऑफ मिक्सचर ऑफ थ्री गुणास इज डिफरेंट इन ईच अंतकरण। तद्यावद् अंतकरणमास्ते तावद् रजोगुण परिणाम रूप इच्छा अपि स्यादेव। यत् क्वचित् इच्छा शास्त्रांतरेषु नैव ज्ञानिनः इच्छादि संभवेत् इत्युक्तम्। सो यत् क्वचित् शास्त्रांतरेषु नैव ज्ञानिनः इच्छादि संभवेत् इत्युक्तम् तत्र अयम् अभिप्रायः। सो सिंस इच्छा इज पॉसिबल एंड सम शास्त्रा सेज ए ज्ञानी डज नॉट हैव इच्छा, how do you resolve this contradiction? So the idea, when some grantha or some acharya says that jnani cannot have an ichha, is the following: jnani ajnani jnanya jnanor dvayor api ichha syadeva. Both the jnani and ajnani have ichha, tathapi what is the difference? Ajnya ichha dina अज्ञः इच्छादीन आत्मधर्मत्वेन जानाति, ज्ञानी तु इच्छा द्युत्पत्ति समयेपि नैव तान् आत्मधर्मत्वेन विजानाति। द टाइप ऑफ हियर सो ज्ञानी नोज एज एंड व्हेन द इच्छा अराइजेस ही नोज दैट इट इज नॉट माय धर्म, इट इज ही क्लियरली नोज। सो विशेष ज्ञान इज देयर, इट इज नॉट नो hearsay or as per whims, but jnani clearly knows that it has nothing to do with me. This ichha has come up in the antakarana, good or bad, I have nothing to do with it. Antakarana has been tainted with punya and papa samskaras, so ichha will come up. How much ever one has worked on the antakarana in the sadhaka avastha, still there will be some vasana which may come up and manifest as raga dvesha ityadi, it has nothing to do with the jnani. Jnani can disown it. That antakarana may drive the stula sharira to act out because of being prabala prarabdha, because of being under the influence of prabala prarabdha. As long as the jnani can disconnect from it, he remains a jnani. He is not an ajnani who gets carried away, dragged, but he simply dissociates from it. And this should be true in all cases, not once in a while. Because this is, you know, very easy to object to and can see the see that a person is making a choice, you know, whenever something which is where the ichha is strong for any person, not a jnani, any person, one may say, you know, it is all due to prarabdha. And somewhere where one does not have ichha, you know, he has dvesha, he may say, this is, you know, you act out. So some places one may say that, no, I mean, all this is something, you know, undesirable to others has been done by one person. That person can claim that it is all due to prarabdha, I didn't do it. But in the case of something good, he claims, starts claiming the, oh no, I did this, claiming kartrutvam there. That kind of a vyavastha, you know, that kind of a behavior is not of a jnani. That is clearly an ajnani. So whenever prarabdha is discussed, one should remember that. Prarabdha versus free will, when it is discussed, there is a mix of both is all right. But whenever one justifies prarabdha, then it should be through and through. It should not be partial. Only in some cases prarabdha, in some cases no prarabdha, this is not right. That is ajnana lakshana. It is not jnana lakshana. Jnana lakshana is whatever good or bad happens, it is all prarabdha. So, because the sharira is completely samarpita. Samarpana should not be partial. Prarabdhaya samarpitam swapuhu means complete surrender. Only then jnani can say that this is all prarabdha. Ajna is considering this as, you know, this is something that I am doing. Atma dharma there is reflexive that it is I who am doing, and that I is Atma really, Brahmatma. This is a misunderstanding. One does not know the Brahmatma, therefore one considers as an actor, the subject of the action, the agent of the action, whereas jnani clearly knows that he isn't. In all cases, not in one case or the other, किंतु अंतकरण परिणामत्वात् तद्धर्मा एव इति तान् संवेति. So he knows that these are antakarana dharmas. Antakarana parinama, and therefore tadharma is antakarana dharma. Ittham jnaninam ichhadi sambhayapi yato na te atma dharmatvena jnanina pratibhanti ataha jnanina ichhadaya na sambhavanti iti. So when the other granthas or acharyas say that jnani does not have ichha, it means that jnani does not consider those ichhas in the antakarana as one's own. It is equivalent to saying that somebody else has some ichha in the antakarana, although you don't know. The difference is we don't know what ichha is there in other's antakarana, and the way we don't claim them also, that I have done this, I have these ichhas. Similarly is the case of jnani. His antakarana is as though somebody else's antakarana. Or a better parallel would be somebody who has a siddhi. You know, there are people who can read others' minds. Let's say jnani is like a siddha who reads others' minds. Which other's mind? His own mind is as though it is a other's mind. What ichha comes up, he has nothing to do with it. Just like others antakarana, you may be able to read the other's mind, but you have no say over that ichha. It's a read only. You can't write the ichha there. Similarly is the case of jnani. As soon as you try to work on the ichha, what does it mean? It means that jnana is not stable. Why is it not stable? Because you still consider that the antakarana is going to affect you. If the ichha has come up, if it is a good ichha, you say, oh, what a blessing. What a blessing is all right. But what a blessing that I have it is a problem, is a trap. And similarly, on the flip side, if some, you know, unbecoming of a jnani kind of an ichha comes up, kama, krodha, ityadi, these ideas, you know, look, you hear some news and then you react to it. That reaction is of the antakarana. Let it have it. As soon as you say, one starts thinking that, oh, this is not, you know, it's very unbecoming of me. As a sadhaka, one thinks that. As a jnani, if one starts thinking that this is very unbecoming of me, then he has owned up the antakarana as a part of him, which is not true. So he is still not having that nishtha, where he still needs an effort. That effort means that the jnani is not completely free from antakarana yet. He does not have nishtha, meaning the samadhi avastha that has been discussed, that ananda is gone. So this is very much of a gray area that people get away by saying anything and everything, but we have to consider the Shuddha Atma, and from the perspective of the Shuddha Atma, what is the connection with any antakarana? That should be the connection of a jnani, uttama jnani. Uttama jnani, because jnana is same, jnani gradations are due to antakarana itself and the connection thereof. So the uttama jnani, who has more of a disconnect with the antakarana, rather has nothing to do with it, he has nothing to claim his own. So that is the idea. This has been discussed a lot. So we are towards the end, and this is a reminder with which the Grantha closes this, because antakarana will always be a topic of discussion. That is why the psyche of the jnani is something which, you know, people find interest in, psyche of anyone. So it has become psychology more than philosophy, really. Philosophy is what? Philosophy is love for knowledge, which is the truth, love for the truth. Psychology is all analysis of the untruth. The truth is what remains when you use the neti neti prakriya and disown everything as a part of you, because you cannot have any parts. What you remain is, after having discarded whatever can be discarded cognitively, what you can dissociate with, when you have dissociated with every name and form, every tag that you can have, then you are free. When you cannot dissociate from anything else anymore, that is the time when you are free. That is the real mukti. It is all neti neti prakriya. Even in Mahavakya, we have seen even positive statements, you are that, means that you are not anything else. Anything that you can come up with, any idea, any notion thrown at you, you can say that it is not true. Sorry. Tatha manovak kayakrutam samvyavaharadikam sarvam na jnanina atmadharmatvena pratibhati kintu kriya samanya manovak kayashritam tatrayo vartate atma tu asangha iti eva pratibhati. It is very clear to the jnani that I am asangha. All this manovak kayakrutam, but it is not atmakrutam. That is the idea. तस्मात् ज्ञानी सर्वव्यवहारेषु कर्ता अपि अकर्ता एव न कर्मणा लिप्यते पापकेन इत्यादि श्रुतेः. जनरली वन डज नॉट हैव एन इश्यू विद पुण्य, दैट्स व्हाई पुण्य इज नॉट मेंशन, बट दिस पाप इंक्लूड्स पुण्य आल्सो. सो पापकेन पुण्ये पुण्येन वा, पापकेन इंक्लूड्स पुण्य, कर्मणा न लिप्यते इत्यादि श्रुतेः. So even when others see him as a karta, he is akarta eva. Jnanodayad anantaram प्रारब्ध कृत शुभाशुभ कर्म फल रूप सुख दुखादिनाम सुख दुखादिना नैव ज्ञानी संबध्यते। सो ज्ञानोदया अनंतरम आफ्टर दि ज्ञानोदया प्रारब्ध कृत शुभ अशुभ कर्म फल रूप सुख दुखादिना नैव ज्ञानी संबध्यते। ज्ञानी इज नॉट कनेक्टेड एसोसिएटेड विथ एनी सुख दुख ड्यू टू एनी शुभ अशुभ कर्म। ऑल दैट इज ड्यू टू प्रारब्ध। प्रारब्ध कृत हैज बीन मेंशन्ड, इट इज ऑल एज एन इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रारब्ध। तदेवम प्रारब्धवशाद् अज्ञवत् ज्ञानिना अपि सर्वव्यवहारः तदनुकूला इच्छादयश्च संभवेयुर् एव। सो व्यवहार एंड इच्छा आर पॉसिबल नॉट फॉर द आत्मा विच इज द रियल स्वरूप ऑफ ज्ञानी बट फॉर ज्ञानी एज सीन बाय अदर्स विद द बॉडी माइंड सेंस कॉम्प्लेक्स द नेम गिवन बाय द सोसाइटी द फॉर्म विच इज cognized by the society and every vyavahara to which the society is the witness has nothing to do with the atma which is the swarupa of jnani. This is same as consider that in the case of a jnani when he was an ajnani, even not ajnani as a sadhaka also, assume that the jnani in earlier avastha, consider Valmiki for example. Valmiki was a robber. You consider he was a robber, a thief, and then you consider Valmiki became a jnani. When he was an ajnani and the worst of them also, one of the worst, having all sorts of papa karma, imagine the connection of Brahma. Brahma jagat karta Ishwara. Would you say that Ishwara is responsible for his karma? You wouldn't. Now go to Nirguna Brahma level and see what is the Nirguna Brahma association with that chaura. There is no association at all. What is our study for? It says that chaura cannot act out anything without the presence of Brahma Tattva, Satchidananda Tattva. The Satta Spurti of the chaura is also due to the same Brahma Tattva, but it has no association. Without it, nothing can take place. Even the chaura karma is not possible without Brahma Tattva being there, but Brahma Tattva has nothing to do with the chaura karma. There is no difference when jnanotpatti takes place and the chaura becomes a Valmiki. There is no difference at all. Absolutely no difference. Whatever was the association earlier, the same association is there. What is the association? There was never an association. By the mere presence, things were getting done. Later also, by mere presence, things will get done. Satta Spurti of the Chaura and the Satta Spurti of the Jnani, which facilitates the Chaura Karma or the Jnani Karma, remains the same. It is the same level of dissociation. There is no difference at all. The only difference is in the jnani who knows that I am not the chaura, I am not a jnani, I am not an ajnani, I am not a jnani also. I am that Brahma who was ever free. That is why ever free. It is not in time that there is Brahmatva bhava. The Brahma bhava, Brahmatvam, is not utpanna at the jnana kshana, jnanutpatti kshana. It has always been there. So knowing that I am free does not mean I am free from this moment. Therefore, people who talk about a moment of moksha are sadly mistaken. They are lost on tattva. It is not that I have become free, I was ever free. So the same dissociation is there, whether with the sharira or not. It is all the same dissociation, same mukti, same Anantyam. So anyway, this was an important point to be made. That's why Sadhu comes back to this. Now, he goes back to the story. The teaching is more or less over. So Shubha Santati Raja Prasanga. The three children, if you recall the story, Tattva Drishti, Adrishti and Tarka Drishti, the three children of this emperor of the three worlds, decided to pursue jnana, pursue moksha really, when the father said that I will hand over. The father, the emperor said that, you know, I have no taste for any of this. He had vairagya and he just mentioned that I will hand over, or he said that, you know, you can each take one loka, each of the three can take one loka, I will walk out. He just said I will walk out. That caused vairagya in the three children. That vairagya was a lot more than the father. In fact, what happened, the story closes back saying that these three children walked out. However, the father did not have that vairagya really. He stayed back. The person whose vairagya caused the vairagya unto others and led to their moksha is somehow trapped in the same position as earlier due to lack of strong vairagya. So that is the end of the story here. Shubha santati namanam rajanam vihaya trayopi tatputra proshitaha abhavan. So these three children had walked out. Tesham putranam charitram kathitam aduna tat pituh prasanga kathyate. So their story has been discussed, but now their father's story is closed. What happened there? The story began with him, but then what happened, we don't know. That is closed here. Putranam pravasat param pituhu rajnyaha tivra vairagya bhavat tad viraha prayuktam dukkham abhut. So pituhu rajnyaha, for this raja there was lot of dukkha. Why? Because his children left. So where is that vairagya? He was going to leave, and as soon as the children left, he had loss of vairagya. Why? Because he had dukkha. He was attached to his children. Manda vairagya vashad vishaya bhogat sukham api na abhut. He had no tivra vairagya. Tivra vairagya abhava was there. Therefore, his children leaving caused him dukkha. Okay. He stayed back. He continued to rule over the three worlds, but was there any sukha? He had every resource possible, but still there was no sukha. Why? Because vairagya was there. It was not tivra, but manda vairagya was there. So he was neither here nor there. He couldn't enjoy the riches and he couldn't walk out also. Therefore, what happened is that neither there was any sukha, not even a bit of sukha, and lot of dukkha due to children leaving. Putra pravasataha titikshayam satyamapi rajyam vihaya gantum na abhud dhairyam. Dhairya wasn't there, therefore he couldn't walk out even after knowing that his children have walked out. Itascha tasya dukkham eva asit satihi tivre vairagye sa rajyam tyaktum shaknuyat. Tadrusha vairagya bhavena rajya parityagaha tasya nabhut. Had there been tivra vairagya, he would have also walked out, but he did not have tivra vairagya, therefore he couldn't give up the rajya. Bhoga shakti rapi tatha nabhut. Because there was manda vairagya, therefore he did not have asakti in bhoga also. So somehow days went by, but then dukkha was continuing and he couldn't enjoy. Tataha ubhayata api tasya dukkham eva asi. So he had dukkha due to children leaving and also because of having all resources but not being useful, not being able to make use of them. He was in dukkha on both fronts. Paramartha niveda bhavat manda vairagya phalabhuta upasya devata jijnyasa eva bhut. So he started thinking, what can I do? to somehow get sukha, some upasana I can do, some devata I can do upasana of, but which devata? Having all sorts of resources, he called a sabha, he called a pandita sabha and asked them as to which devata is upasya, who can take away my dukkha. That is the idea there. So that is the part of the story. I'll just go through it, which wherever there is a story, not much of tattva is there, we'll speed through. Shubha santate pandita samaje ko deva sada jagarti iti prashnaha. So his idea was, which devata will take care of me, who is always concerned about his bhakta or his devotee, whatever you think, his follower. I want that kind of devata who never sleeps. Meaning never sleeps means he never sleeps to the call. He wakes up to the call of the devotee. I want that kind of devata who can take away my dukkha. This is the idea that Shubha Santati Raja had. Shubha Santate he manda vairagya Shubha Santate he manda vairagyodayaha api mahabhagya vashadeva jataha. Even that manda bhagya, one should hold on to, one can build upon it. The spark can become a fire. Therefore, even smashana vairagya, if one fuels, if one inquires into that, holds on to it, it can lead to real vairagya, facilitating moksha, making a person adhikari. This is what even the Sringeri Acharya says in the Vyakhya on Viveka Chudamani. He says, okay, there is smashana vairagya, jihasa vairagya, but let it be there, you start holding on to that and build on it. It is your capital. It may be less, but you can earn on that. You can multiply that if you hold on to it. So don't let it go. That is the idea. Tena cha tasya ko deva upasya iti jijnyasa samajani. So this jijnyasa was not just, you know, some thought, passing thought. Samajani means it samyaktaya ajani. This question came up and he held on to that question. Which devata is upasya, worthy of upasana, worthy to commit completely to? So the regular puja and all is okay, but can you commit to an ishta devata? Sarvasva. That idea came up in his mind. Pandita Varan, and it was so strong that he actually inquired and took it to the end. Pandita Varan anaya yathochitam asanadishu upaveshya purusharthalabhaya sarvairapi janaihi aradhyaha anidraha aswapnaha sadabhakta jana paripalana vyagrascha ko deva iti paprachya. So he asked this Pandita Sabha after, you know, treating them with respect, doing all satkara. In the sabha he asked, which for purushartha labha, for parama purushartha in the end, by all janas, who is the devata who is worthy of worship, who is the deva who is worship aradhya, aradhya devata kaha. So aradhya devaha kaha, or aradhya devata kaha, also ka also is possible. Who is anidraha? Who, you know, you cannot say that, oh, the bhakta is in trouble, but the Lord is sleeping. It happens, you know, you go to the court, their lordships are sleeping, so you have to wait till the courts open. There are, you know, we have heard of so many cases where the judges are sleeping and the person has to wait for nyaya. But anidraha deva, I want that deva who is not sleeping when I call him out. There is no time. Whenever I need, I get a response, favorable one at that. This is the idea that the bhakta had here, he wanting to be that kind of a bhakta. Asapna, who is not into some kind of other world, busy in some other world. Swapna, nidra, swapna, ityadi. So this is the idea. And there, sada bhakta jana paripalana vyagrascha, who is eager to help out the bhakta. Who is that? Shrutva etad raja vachanam panditavareshu kaschit evam prativaktum upachakrami. So one of the panditas said, I know the answer, I'll tell you. So he says, Vishnu upasakasya uttaram. What is? He is a Vishnu upasaka. So his answer is what? Vishnu. Vishnu is the devata. Don't go to anyone else. So all these ideas are now discussed in this part of the section of the grantha. Bho Rajan sakala vedanta shiromani bhutam vasudevam shivaha virinchischa nityam sevate. So what is the idea of looking into this? This is the only part which has not been looked into, this Vichara Sagara. What about these Vaishnavas, Shaivas, Devi Upasakas? What about them? Ganapatya. There are so many. So what about these deities? It has come up in one way, but then as Upasya Devata, how are these, you know, gradations to be looked into? Are there any gradations, and which should be followed for Purushartha Labha? So Sakala Vedanta Shiromani Bhutam, one who is the Vedanta Shiromani also, in all Vedanta also, who is being talked about? Dvaitin Se Vishnu. So this Vishnu, Vaishnavas Se Vishnu, Vasudevam, whom even Shiva and Brahma worship on a daily basis as a Nitya Karma. They have Nitya Karma to worship Vishnu. Therefore, Vishnu is one who is Upasya. That is the answer. Shankar Chakra Gadadhara. So, Shankar Chakra Dharaha. So, Gada can be brought in. Sarvajana Hitakari Padma Gadadhara. Okay, so more is there. So, Shankar Chakra Dharaha Sarvajana Hitakari Padma Gadadharaha Paropakari Cha Sa Vasudevaha Mangala Murtihi Dayanidhischa Ittam Bhutaha Mahavishnuhu Nija Bhakta Jana Chitta Vijnaha Tattad Bhakta Vishtam Shivam Prayachati. So, if the form is discussed, he is a Mangalamurti, Dayanidhi, he is the treasure of compassion. So, he will take care of you the way you deserve. So, this kind of Mahavishnu is Upasya, so by everyone. And he gives whatever is Ishta to you. He is ever at your call. Shakti Ganesh Surya Shivadaya Sarvepi Devaha Tad Ajnya Vamshavada. So Ajnya Vamshavada. So not really sure how to read this together. Devaha Tad Ajnya Vamshavada. So Tad Ajnya Vamshavada. Just a part of his order, you know. They are completely under his orders. They are doing what they are doing because of just a mere mention by him. By a mere mention of, or given a direction by Vishnu, delegated work. So he has delegated by just mere statement, he has delegated work to the other devatas. So all these are at his service. So it says Vamsha, if you have a errata, so Ajnya Vashad would make sense, but here is, if you say Ajnya, so Devaha, I'm not sure, I'll let it go, but you get the idea, I explain the idea, I don't want to spend a lot of time on this, so it's okay. We understand the bhava there, so I'll let it be. Iti Bharata Padma Purana Deshu Nrsinya Tapaniya Rama Tapaniya Gopala Tapani Tapini Adi. So Bharata Padma Purana Deshu, we have seen the Puranas in Mahabharata also, it is discussed. He says Padma Purana also, there is a discussion of Vishnu. Then Nrsinya Tapani, Rama Tapani, Gopala Tapanyadi, Upanishad Sucha Uchyate. So there are many other Upanishads also which talk about Vishnu as the Upasya Devata for all other Devatas. Sarvancha Jagat विष्णु स्वरूपात समजनी सर्व पीड़ा बहर्ता सैव आराधयन्ति च सर्वे अपि एनमेव विविधम अवतीर्य देवानां सहायम अकरोत् तस्मात् विष्णुरेव सर्वे उपास्यः नान्यत् उपास्यं तत्समस्ति दैवतम्। सो वी गेट द आईडिया द वैष्णवा सेज दैट विष्णु इज उपास्य ही ब्रिंग्स हिज ओन प्रूफ फॉर इट एंड देन ही सेज ही विल टेक अवे ऑल योर पीड़ा ही इज द जगतकर्ता और द एंटायर प्रपंच हैज कम फ्रॉम विष्णु देयरफॉर विष्णु इज उपास्य विष्णुः अंतरंग भक्तः अपि शिवः न उपास्यं स्वरूपं धत्ते इवन शिवा शुड नॉट बी वर्शिप व्हाई शिववत् सह अमंगल स्वरूपी सॉरी शववत् सह अमंगल स्वरूपी सो वैष्णवास हैव द्वेष टुवर्ड्स शिवा दे से ही शववत् सह अमंगल स्वरूपी ही शुड बी सेट असाइड व्हाई बिकॉज़ ही इज लाइक अ शवा इट सीम्स गोइंग अराउंड इन स्मशान एटसेट्रा So all these ideas they bring up and say that Shiva should not be worshipped. Tataha asau asmakam na dhyana arghaha. So you don't do dhyana on Shiva. Similarly, you don't do dhyana on Shiva, says the Vaishnava. Bhasma damru gaja charma kapala maladharaha ayam anyasmai katham kshemankaraha syat. So one who himself does not have enough resources, what resources will he give you? This is the question that Vaishnavas ask about Shiva Bhaktas. Tatputra Ganesha api tathaiva. What about his putra Ganesha? He is also not worship worthy. Why? Not upasya. So, Gananam adhipati. So, this is Makara. Gananam adhipati tvena shreshta ganapati rapi. नरमृग मिश्रितम रूपम दत्ते सो दे गो वेरी लिटरल टू इंसल्ट दे से दैट गणेश इज हाफ एन एलिफेंट सो हिज हेड इज एलिफेंट सो ही इज अ मिक्स ऑफ नर एंड मृग केचन हठात् देवी ध्यानम कुर्वन्ति सो दिस इज हेतु व्हाट इज हेतु नरमृग मिश्रितम बीइंग सो गणेश कैन नॉट हेल्प यू आउट केचन हठात् देवी ध्यानम कुर्वन्ति हठात् नाउ दिस इज अनदर थिंग सो ड्यू टू हठा यू डू देवी उपासना शी इज आल्सो नॉट वर्शिप वर्दी सेज दी वैष्णव ततः तत्समान रूपतां लभन्ते सो दे बिकम लाइक देवी बिकॉज़ दे यूज फोर्सिबली वर्शिप देवी विच इज नॉट टू बी डन एज पर देम स्त्री स्वरूपम तु अतिनिंद्यम अशुच्य गणितावगुण युक्तम विचित्र विभवाश्रयम कपट स्वरूपम नित्यपराधीनंच सो ही यूजेस सम ऑड स्टोरीज टू इंसल्ट वुमेन एंड बाय इंसल्टिंग वुमेन ही सेज दैट यू विल बिकम लाइक देम बाय बिकमिंग लाइक देवी सो ही इज डिस्करेजिंग दी किंग बाय सेइंग दैट यू आर अ मैन यू नो यू शुडंट बी लाइक अ वुमेन If you start worshipping Devi, you will become like a woman. And then he shows all the flaws of the woman. Each gender has its own pluses and minuses. He focuses on something and says, does some aropa and says, you will become like him. Basically what he wants to praise Vishnu. So you can take it as Nahinindyanaya also, but unfortunately this is too literal for Dvaitins. It is not Nahinindyanaya. They use Ninda and they are committed to that Ninda alone. If you look at Dvaitins today, they are all focused on Ninda of the others than focusing on their own sadhana. Be a bhakta, okay, but be a bhakta complete. Do not go insulting other devatas. They don't have such rules. Nonetheless, Idrisha Swarupabhilashi Yahanaraha Sa Gardhavatulyaha Tam Sevatu. So he says that one who worships anyone but Vishnu is similar to a donkey. So this is the kind of insult that a Vaishnava throws at others. Surya api. What about Surya? Pratyaksha Devata. So Surya Narayana we say. But if you don't see him as Vishnu, then not worthy. even if you see him as Vishnu, then why not go to Vishnu directly? Why remain with Surya? This is the kind of idea that Vaishnavas have. Surya api aharnisham avishravam antarikshe alat chakravad bambhramiti. So there is a sanadyanta prayoga there. Bambhramiti. Tad upasakah api tathaiva sada chanchala syat. So like Surya, who goes here and there throughout the day, he is traveling. Day 24 hours, Surya is on a run. Scientifically, he is still, but then you see him moving here and there. So there is a story as to Surya is searching for a beautiful partner. Someone told him that she is in the west, so he goes from east to west. She isn't there. Then someone says that she went to the east, and then he comes back to the east. So all the time he is searching for a beautiful partner, it seems. So there is some, you know, cock and bull story. And these people will use that and say, he is running around here and there, he himself is helpless, what help will he give you? The entire Veda Moola Mantra Gayatri is about Savita Devata, Savitra Devata, Surya. Surya Antargata Brahma Tattva. However, the Vaishnava will say, don't go to Surya also, don't do Surya Upasana also. Otherwise, you will also become chanchala like him. Tasmat samutsujanya had. This is very. I think there are some typos here. I can't make out. Samutsrujya. Okay. Utsrujya. Okay. So that's what it is. There is. This must be a ru there. So okay. Tasmat samutsrujya anyaha devataha sarvaha sada prabuddhah Mahavishnureva sada sarvehi sevaniya iti janihi. So he tells the king that give up everyone completely and focus on Vishnu. No other devata should you even think about, let alone do puja. Who is upasya? Vishnu eva. Tat puja dhyanadi vidhi prakara Narada Pancharatra Granthe katitaha. We have seen Narada Pancharatra Grantha, which is Dharma Shastra. All Vaishnava Granthas are part of Narada Pancharatra. So you can study that, and I can teach you, says this Vishnu Upasaka Pandita. Vishnu Upasana Atiriktam Upasana Chatushtem Yajyapi Loka Prasiddham Tatapi Tatra Ekeka Upasana Nindaya Smarta Upasana Mapi Nishiddham Bhavati. So although other Upasanas are famous, he says don't do those. All his Panchayatana Puja and all that you discard. Hold on only to Vishnu in those five. Panchapi Devata Samabuddhya Yatra Upasyante Tat Smarta Upasanam Ityuchyate. So where you have Samata Bhava in all the five Devatas, you may keep one Pradhana, you know, Kula Devata Ityadivat. But still, Samata Bhava is there in all five. That is this Panchayatana Puja called as Smarta Upasana. Same at the level of, you know, Manasa Puja. It is all Upasana. But that is not worth it, says the Vaishnava. Panchayatana Pujanam Api Shivadinam Chaturanam Vishnu Samata Bodhanat Smarta Upasanam Eva. So Panchayatana Puja is also because of Samata with which you are doing the puja, that bhava is there, it makes it a mental activity and can be considered upasana. Shiva upasakasya uttaram. The Shiva upasaka is perturbed by this. He answers to this. Shiva upasaka kaschan munihi purvoktam shrutva ativa sankruddha atitaram cha raktanetra eva eva maha. So his blood is boiling now. What kind of, you know, Shava Sama and all that nonsense has been talked about by the Vishnu Upasaka. Shiva Upasaka is angry now. He says, hey Rajan, shrunu me vachaha. So he decides to pay back in kind. शिवः एव उपास्यन् विष्णुः सन्ति च कोटिशः अत्र प्रमाणानि. He says, what all that he has said has no pramana. I will tell you with pramana that Shiva is the only upasya devata. So Shaivite answers the Raja now. There are crores of pramanas to Shiva being upasya. Bhaktavishta sarvasvapradaha anyaha tatsamaha kovasti lokatrayapi. Mahavishnuna yachitaha sakalam api svakiyam aishwaryam tasmai dattva. Swayam bhasmaiva jatte. So all the aropa done by the Vaishnava that he has, you know, he himself has bhasma, he covers himself in bhasma, hardly has anything to wear, uses an elephant skin and goes around. What is he going to help you? What kind of help can he offer? He himself is helpless, is the aropa done by Vaishnava. The Shaivite answers that Vishnu has got all his riches because Shiva gave it all away to him. He is a Vairagi. He gave it all away to him. Vishnu is Vishnu because of Shiva. Shiva giving him that. So Shiva himself can help the devotee. He himself stays in solitude without any resources while he gives you all the resources. That is the idea behind it. So Mahavishnuna yachitaha sakalam api svakiyam aishwaryam tasmai dattva svayam bhasmaiva dhatte ataeva charma karotikadikam api dadhara nahi tasya asti uttama adhamatva sadhu asadhutvadi bheda vivechanam. So he is beyond all this bheda, sadhu asadhu, all these ideas are not there because he has transcended all that. He transcendence figuratively, he is already beyond that. He does not have any value for these riches. He does not think that, you know, bhasma is, you know, all this smashana, all these are asadhu. He has no such division at all. This is your division. Sarvam samam eva tasya sama eva cha asau sarvasya swayam nagno bhutva vairagyan na param sukasya janakam kutrapi satsadhanam ityupadishati. One who has Vairagya, he has Paramasukha. So Shiva is Ananda Swarupa. He does not need Anandra through anything else. Ittham Mahadata Paramashiva Eva Naranarya Adinam Kashyam Mriyamananam Shigram Swasvayujya Muktim Praichati. One who dies in Kashi gets Mukti. This is a Purana Vachana. That is all possible due to Shiva. Vishnu cannot give you all that. नचते गर्भवासादि दुःखं पुनः प्राप्नुवन्ति. सो व्हाट इज दैट मुक्ति? दे विल नॉट गेट जन्म, दैट इज मुक्ति. शिव समाह सर्वान् दिव्य भोगान् भुञ्जते तदा च अयम् परमशिवः लैङ्गं शरीरं विहाय अद्वैत ब्रह्मात्म प्राप्त्युपायम् उपदिशति. सो वन बिकम शिव समा डाइंग इन काशी एंड देन this Paramashiva gives that person Advaita Upadesha. So Shiva is Upasya. Vishnu Svabhavah Tu Evam Iti Shruyate. Then he goes on and gives an answer to the Vishnu Upasaka who attacked Shiva. Sahi Bhaktamatra Parirakshana Paraha. He says, your Vishnu does help out others, but whom does he help? He helps only his own devotees. He does not help everyone. Na abhakta rakshakaha. So he will not come and rescue anyone and everyone. He will help only those who favor him, those who... So he pays back. He pays back what you offer to him. Otherwise, he is not going to help you out. Vyasascha avochat skande purane. And then he quotes Vyasa. He says, this is not what I am saying. He says, Vyasacharya has said in the same Purana that you refer to, Vyasacharya has said that Vishnu is not going to help others. Where does he say that? He says, Hari Sevakaha Sevyascha Haraha Iti. So Hari Sevakaryali Sevyaha. Who should be actually Upasya? One who is Sevya, not Sevaka. Hara Shiva is Sevyaha Upasyaha, whereas Hari is Sevaka. Don't go to Sevaka. This is what what Vyasacharya says the Shaiva. Rameshwari Ramachandrena Paramashivaha Pujita iti cha. And it is said that Rameshwara, even the Vishnu avatara Rama had worshipped Shiva. Bharata Padma Puranadishu Sarva Devebhyaha Harihi Shrestha Ityuktehe Naswarthe Tatparyam Kintu Bharata Tatparya Paryaya Lochanayam Paramashivasya Eva Ishwaratvam Pratiyate. He says all those quotations given by the Vaishnava is not their end goal in itself. If you study further, you know that one who is praised, he himself is a sevaka of Shiva. So why would you go to a sevaka? You should go to the savior, one who is served, not the servant. Itham eva cha appaya dikshitakhya vidushapi alekhi. So even Bhagavan Appaya Dikshita has said this. See, Appaya Dikshita was a Shiva Bhakta, but he was an Advaitin. He said that I have Ishtadevata Shiva, although I don't make any Bheda between the two. But if you do attack Shiva, he says, I will pay you back in kind. I will show you how Shiva is superior to Vishnu if you attack Shiva. I have no Bheda between the two. This is how Appaya Dikshita did Samanvaya also. And he says that I can't take it that you attack Shiva. I don't have any problem saying Vishnu is great. So is Shiva. I prefer Shiva. If you attack Shiva though, I will show you how Vishnu is inferior to Shiva by Pramana. And this is the work that Appaya Dikshita had taken up. So I'll not go through the Tippana where the quotations are given and background of Appaya Dikshita is mentioned. What Sarva Itihasa Purananam Tatparyam. So he has shown by quoting Itihasa Puranas as to how Shiva is superior than Vishnu. Bharata Tatparya Prasangaha Tu Evam Tu Ayam Eva. So what is the Tatparya Vishaya in whatever has been quoted by the Vaishnava? Ashwatthamna Narayanagneya Adi Astra Prayoge Krute Pi Bahusainya Varanam Vinana Kaschit Pandaveshu Mamara. So this Mahabharata that is brought out as a Pramana by the Vaishnava, what is really to be seen there? When Ashwatthamna Narayanagneyadyastra Prayoge Kruteyapi Bahusainya Maranam Vinana Kaschit Pandaveshu Mamara. Ashwatthama tried all the weapons. Even after using all the weapons which have been invoked through grace of those devatas, still not even he was able to kill many of the Pandava Sena, but not Pandavas themselves. Not even a single Pandava was hurt by these weapons. Tadacha sa ratham vihaya dhanurvedam acharyancha jikritya vanan jagama. He said that this is all useless, all this dhanurvidya that I have studied, what is use is this, that I cannot even kill a single Pandava. So he retired to forest saying that all this is useless. Tada Vyasaha tam drishtva idamaha he brahman acharya vedadi nindanakarya. He says that all this shastra that you are doing ninda of and their acharyas also, that should not be done. Said Vyasacharya to Ashwatthama. Etau hi Krishnarjunau Naranarayanatmakau. Why are you unable to kill the Pandavas? Is because Arjuna and Krishna are Naranarayana. So this Naranarayana combination being there, you are unable to hurt them. एताभ्याम अत्यंतं पूजितः परमेश्वरः तद्भक्त्यतिशय वशात् तदायत्तः भूत्वा महादेवः त्रिशूली तद्रथस्य पुरतः स्थित्वा तत्प्रयुक्त अस्त्रशस्त्रादीनां सामर्थ्यं विनाशयति इति. He says that these Naranarayanas, Krishna and Arjuna are protected by Shiva, who is there right at the front of the Ratha. Whatever weapons you throw at them, they are destroyed by the Shiva. You cannot even reach them. This is Shiva Mahima. Ittham Mahabharate Mahadeva Krupaya Eva Narayana Swarupasyapi Shri Krishnasya Vibhutyatishaya Abhuditi Siddhyati. So what is the tatparya there in Mahabharata? When you quote that, oh, Krishna is absolutely great, Vishnu Avatara, therefore Vishnu is great, Shiva is not Upasya. Oh, Shiva protected even Krishna. That is the tatparya vishaya, says the Shaiva. So this is all an aside. But why? Because we come across all these Upasakas and Vishnu Bhaktas, Shiva Bhaktas. So such ideas are there, we have to deal with them. So this one-upmanship is there all over, even to date. Tasmad Vishnu Charitra Pratipadakah Grantha Sarva Api Shiva Seva Adhikyam Pratipadayati Teshu Granteshu Vishnu Sevya Taya Uchyate Bharata Prasangavalattu Sa Vishnu Shiva Bhakta Iti Siddhyati Ataha Saeva Paramashiva Paramasevya Bhavati Ittham Appaya Dikshita Sakaleshu Vaishnava Granteshu Shiva Eva Tatparine Pratipadyate Iti Pratipadaya प्रतिपादयामास हरिस्तु शिवभक्ताग्रगण्यः महादेवः महेश इति च तस्य शिवस्य नाम. शिव इज कॉल्ड एज महादेव महेश. भगवान अप्पय्य दीक्षित हैज एनालाइज दिस महाभारत स्टोरी एज कोटेड बाय वैष्णव एंड टर्न दैट स्टोरी अराउंड ऑन देम सेइंग दैट शिव इज सुपीरियर. So, Shiva is Paramasevya, whereas Hari can be considered as Paramasevaka. So, Vishnu is Sevaka, Shiva is Sevya, thereby you go to Sevya, not to Sevya Bhakta Harihi. And that is the reason that Shiva is not called as only Deva, he is Mahadeva. He is not Isha Ishwara, he is Mahesha. In Karnataka, if you go and you look at some Devasthana, which Devasthana? Shiva Devasthana is not called as Shivalinga and Shiva Devasthana, it is called as Ishwara, Ishwara Devasthana. Vishnu Devasthana is called as Vishnu Murti Devasthana, Vishnu Devasthana. But Shiva temple is not called as Shiva temple. When you say Ishwara, it is Shiva. In Karnataka, all over, wherever you go, I don't know about other places, but when Ishwara is mentioned, Ishwara is who? Ishwara is Shiva, not Vishnu. Ishwara temple means Shiva's temple. That is why he is called as Mahesha. Not only Isha, Mahancha aso Ishwarascha, iti Maheshwaraha, Mahancha aso Ishascha, Maheshaha. So this itself tells you, Mahadeva, Mahesha, tells you that Shiva is superior, says the Shaiva. Taditaresham Devanam Devaha Ishwara Ityeva Prasiddhi. Others may be called as Deva Ishwara, but when you say Mahesha and Mahadeva, it means no one else but Shiva. So that is proof enough. Shiva Shabdasya Mangalam Ityartha. And what is Shiva? Shiva is Shubham, Mangala, auspicious. The name itself tells you it is auspicious. Khashriyasam Shivam Bhadram Kalyanam Mangalam Shuvitya Maraha. So Amarakosha says this. Mangalam Shubham. Shiva means Bhadra, Kalyana, Mangala and Shubha, says Amarakosha. Shiva Danyad Ashivam Sarvam. So when you say Shiva is Mangala, is Vishnu Shiva? No, Vishnu is Ashiva. If Vishnu is Ashiva, then Vishnu is Amangala, because Shiva means Mangala. If Shiva means Mangala, Shiva means Shubha, Shiva means Kalyana, Shiva means Bhadra, then what will Ashiva Vishnu mean? Ashiva Vishnu will mean Abhadra, Kalyana, Amangala, Shubha. This is the idea that the Shaiva presents and pays back in the same kindness that Vishnu Bhakta had towards Shiva. Amangala Swarupa Eva. Ashiva means Amangala Swarupa Eva. Ataha Vihaya Ataha Vihaya Enan Sarvan Eva Devan. Amangala Swarupan Shiva Eva Ekaha Jeya Sarvairapi Shivankaraha. So Amangala Swarupan Sarvan Vihaya, having given up all other devatas who are Amangala, you should take to only Mangala Rupa Shiva. Apija Visham Drishtva Bhayam Abhut Tasitresham Sarvesham Devanam. So it's all laughable, you know, it's all funny. Attacking each other's devatas is all funny. Because there is no Tatpare Vishya there at all. It is only one-upmanship, it is no different than, it is all human behavior. It has nothing to do with the devatas themselves. Devatas will be laughing at this. So looking at the, when the Samudra Manthana was done, when Visha came up, everyone ran away. Only Shiva stood by there. Tad Visham kanthe eva niruddhya tesham ayam bhayam apanunod. Tatsuta Ganeshaha Yadyapi Sakalan Vignan Sadhya Eva Apahanti Tathapi Karya Gunasya Karanadhinatva Niyamat Sarva Vignana Mulata Vinashakara Shiva Eva Iti Vidnyayam. So that Visha which came up, that was so poisonous that just being around that Visha, one won't survive. And it would have consumed the entire world had Shiva not, you know, swallowed it and held in its kantha. So it is said that Parvati was very upset that Shiva drank the poison to save others. So she held his neck and didn't allow the Visha to go within. So that is why he is Neela Kantha. The Neela Rupa Visha is still there in his neck. What about Ganesha though, who is said to be Mangala Murti, Prathama Upasthya? That Ganesha is also Shivaputra. So his Karya, all the power of the Karya is due to the Karana. Therefore, all the powers of Ganesha are due to the powers of Shiva. Therefore, the Shiva Bhakta says that Ganesha is also not Upasya. Why? Because his Karya, why go to the Karya when you can stay with the Karana? Karyagunasya karanadhinatva niyamat sarva vignana moolata vinashakara shiva eva iti vidnyam. So when you say that Ganesha takes away all the vignas, avigna karaha, is because Shiva really does it. Ganesha is nimitta matra. Janana maranadi dukkha rupa vignaha sarvepi shivadhyana matra deva vinashyanti iti vidyat. So what should you know? All the vignas like Janana, Marana and everything in between, all these dukkhas go away due to Shivadhyana. Only due to Shivadhyana. Itham sarvaihi sadasevyaha sadashiva eva. So that sadashiva is sadasevyaha. Shiva is sevya and sadashiva is sadasevyaha. Pashupata tantre shiva puja vidhaya nirupyante tadukta puja vidhanena stuti namaskara adinacha Shiva Charana Sakshatkaro Jayeta. So you will get Sakshatkara, Shiva Charana Sakshatkara by following Shiva Puja Vidhis as described in the Pashupata Tantra. Narada Pancharatra Matam Sutra Bhashya Abhyam Vyakhandi. Further he says all this Narada Pancharatra which is mentioned by the Vaishnava, Khandana has been done in Brahma Sutra and Bhashya. So one should not follow Narada Pancharatra. One should follow Shiva Puja Pashupata Tantra. Tad Anurodhi Ramanujadi Navina Vaishnava Matam Api Kalpataru Vyakhyana Rupe Parimale Samyak Khanditam. So if some Puravakshi says that, no, all this Khandana has been done, all right, but then the Vaishnava Sampradaya, Dvaita and the Vaishnava Sampradaya which came up after that, what about them? They have established that Vishnu is Upasya. So that has also been answered in Kalpataru, not in Bhashya, because it all followed Bhashya. The Sampradayas have, so-called Sampradayas have popped up आफ्टर दी भाष्य आफ्टर भगवान भाष्यकार सो दिस सूत्र एंड ब्रह्म सूत्र एंड भाष्य डू नॉट हैव देयर खंडना बट एक्चुअली दैट खंडना इज ऑल्सो देयर इट इज ऑल री इन्वेंटिंग द व्हील द फाउंडेशन हैज ऑलरेडी बीन रिफ्यूटेड However, if you want specific refutation of these matas also, they can be seen in Kalpataru, which is by Appaya Dikshita. So Kalpataru is a commentary. Parimala is a commentary on Kalpataru. So here there is a tippana. So Sri Shankara Bhagavatpada Virachita Brahma Sutra Bhashya Vyakhyana Rupasya Vachaspati Krita Bhamati Nibandasya Kalpataru iti Vyakhya. So on Bhamati there is a Bhamati is a टीका ऑन भाष्य ऑन ब्रह्मसूत्र एंड ऑन दैट भामति देयर इज अ टीक व्याख्या कॉल्ड कल्पतरु तस्य च व्याख्यानम परिमलम एंड ऑन कल्पतरु देयर इज अ व्याख्यान कॉल्ड परिमला तच्च अप्पय दीक्षित रचितम इति दक्षिण देशे प्रसिद्धि सो कल्पतरु टीका कॉल्ड परिमला इज बाय भगवान अप्पय दीक्षित सो कल्पतरु व्याख्यान रूपे परिमले सम्यक खंडितम So in Parimala, there is a Khandana. Parimala on Kalpataru, which is on Bhamati, which is on Bhashya, which is on Brahma Sutra. So Bahuduram. So to understand that level, a lot of study needed. So if somebody is more interested to say that, no, I want specific refutation of this Mata, one can study that. So anyway, we'll stop here. We already overshot. So we'll look at other Devata, Upasana, how they are more superior. As per their own matas and then land on this section we'll close the section going through this next time onwards I'll speed through we'll look at only some important points in these each of these otherwise everyone has a one manship there सुकनित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर् दृक्यते पारं सर्ववेदान्ते वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेव अन्नमत्वं इति निश्चितामतिः नमस्ते
नमस्ते